Nope. Hello, 안녕하세요. I'm Sean Rage. Welcome to Cinemarea, where we only talk about South Korean movies and dramas. Recently, I reviewed Steel Rain, and although that movie wasn't nearly perfect, there were still aspects that I really enjoyed. Mostly Kwak Do-won's and Jung Woo-sung's performance and the chemistry between them. So today, let's take a look at his sequel, Steel Rain 2 Summit, or Kangchabi 2, or is it Kangchabi-e? There's two number systems in Korea. Jeongsangwadam. The movie is special in the way that Jung Woo-sung and Kwak Do-won is back, but they portray completely different characters. This time, Jung Woo-sung is the president of South Korea, and Kwak Do-won is a North Korean soldier, and he's kind of the villain in the movie. They're joined by Yoo Yeon-seok, who I loved in Mr. Sunshine, and Angus Macfadyen. He's the president of the United States. The story of Steel Rain 2 is pretty complex. Again, like his predecessor, there are a lot of threads, but the point is, Japan is trying to engage in a war with China, but secretly they're after South Korea. There are a lot of political powers at play, you really have to pay attention to understand what is going on. But the real story is as follows. A summit is being held between the North and South Korean leaders, joined by the President of the United States. While Kwak Do-won's character leads a coup, kidnaps the three leaders, puts them on a nuclear submarine, and tries to bomb Japan. This film is terrible. But before I tear this one to pieces, let me state this. If you love political movies, if you love watching political talks and tactics, you might find yourself in heaven watching this film. And for the rest of us, avoid this movie like a plague. I'm not gonna lie, at first I was intrigued. I thought it was a great idea to have the lead actors from the previous movie portray completely different characters this time. The problem is not this. The problem is that the whole movie is just sitting down and talking. Seriously, the whole movie is like that. People sit down and talk, and then they sit down and talk. They argue and talk, and then they sit down and talk. And those conversations are about as interesting as watching grass grow. And since the American president only speaks English, there's a lot of repetition in the dialogue because someone always has to translate something to someone. And all it does is it stretches the movie's runtime. Meanwhile, the audience falls asleep. It's a highly uneventful movie, there's actually very little happening, the action is also really sparse and honestly not very interesting. And on top of that, almost the whole movie takes place in small confined spaces, be it an office at a Blue House or a cabin inside a submarine. It's claustrophobic, but most of all, boring as hell. But there's a bigger problem. There are no characters in this movie. The main characters in the previous one were pretty great, they felt like human beings. This time, by the end, Jung Woo-sung gets closest to an actual character, but the others are just cardboard boxes. I was especially annoyed by the character of the US president. He acts like an arrogant asshole throughout the whole movie. He's portrayed as a stereotypical, selfish, arrogant, American asshole. I've got two problems with that. One, no president would actually act like this. And two, I've met Americans before and they were nothing like this. South Korean movies are usually so strong when it comes to characters that this is infuriating. And once again, just like with his predecessor, the third act is boring and anticlimactic. Trust me, you won't care about anything that happens. And the whole thing takes place underwater with lots of CGI, and not very good CGI. The only positive thing I can say about this movie that just like with its predecessor, the creators made a lot of effort distinguishing the northern and southern dialects. This time the speech of the North Korean characters are subtitled because it sounds so different. I don't know how close they actually got to the actual North Korean dialects, but it sure sounded different. And since I'm interested in the Korean language, I really enjoyed that aspect of it. But that's about it. Steel Rain 2 is a boring, uninspired, poorly written, poorly executed movie. I can only recommend this to someone who loves political talks. Other than that, stay away from this one. I love Kwak Do-won as an actor, I really like Jung Woo-sung and Yoo Yeon-seok as well, but they can't save a bad script. I'm utterly disappointed and I'm gonna give Steel Rain 2 45%. This movie belongs in the trash bin. That's it for today guys, thank you all very very much for watching, like and subscribe, and see you all very soon. 다음 시간에 만나요, bye!